Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Mechanism 110. Today, I would like to do some upgrading of these machines, first of all, and I want to make sure they're all upgraded to elite status. So, what do we need for that? Basically, what we need is some tier upgrades. So, what we got is we've got the basic tier upgrade, the advanced, and the elite. There's actually very little use for the ultimate, as far as I can see, because we don't have any ultimate machines. So what we need are reinforced alloys, which are diamond dust, called compressed diamond with enriched alloys. So we need, I think we've got 7 machines, so we're going to need 28 of those, plus another 4 for each one. So we're going to need, in here, we're going to need 8 times 7 is 56. So that's quite a few, but we can do that, no problem at all. So we shall actually do 64. So the first thing we're going to do is to make sure we've got some enriched alloy, which we've got plenty of at the moment. In fact, I've already got a few of these already. 60, in fact, I've got enough actually, so let's use these ones I've got here. So we needed gold, and I think we needed some wooden planks. We've got 5 here, probably need 5 will be enough, I think. Yes, I think 5 is enough. So let's get these upgrades done. Right, 5 upgrades. I've also got some advanced upgrades for the other machines which have not upgraded to advanced status so far. So here we have, these are the 3 we can do straight away. And here is this is a basic injecting factory. So if we have a look at this one, we can simply right click the tier upgrade on this one, and if there's any switches, they'll get knocked off. There are no switches on it, so let's upgrade that one, and also let's upgrade it again, and we'll do the same for each one of these machines. Fairly straightforward once you've built the stuff. In fact, it's not that expensive. Let's get the switches down here and put the 3 switches back onto these machines. And they're all now in the off position. The metallurgic infuser you cannot upgrade, and neither can't either do the osmium compressor either. I don't think there's any upgrades for this that we haven't got in already, except for muffling. I'll do muffling as well. So this is the last one, of course, and this has got we can do this to advance first of all, because it's a basic smelting factory, and we can then make it elite as well. So there we go. Now there's basically no changes in here except for we get 7 slots instead of 3. So let's have a look what upgrades we've basically got here. It looks to me as though we need to make lots of muffling upgrades. Anyway, I'll put the switch back on here and we shall go and make some muffling upgrades. Now they are the same basic recipe as all of the other upgrades for mechanism. So in this case, we want steel, if I remember correctly, and we need to do at least 7 machines. We'll do 8 upgrades, and it's 8 times 4 is 32. I'll tell you what we'll do. Let's back in half that. And the other thing it needs is, if I remember rightly, it's glass and gold. But no, maybe it's just enriched alloy and glass. So we need the muffling upgrade. So it is glass in that one, with steel dust. So steel dust have got 32, that's fine. So we need this gold, we need 64 of these, and we also need 64 glass, which we haven't yet got, I don't think. So I quickly go and make a stack of that. And of course that'll go through a lot faster now, because we've got a lot more capacity. In fact, I've almost doubled the capacity of this. So let's put that in this tank, in this chest here. Got another one here, of course, 47. And then they should come across here. But I've left the switches off, so we'll turn the switches back on. And as you can see, it's whipping through these really fast. So that 64 will done in a few seconds. So we need another few of those. Let's get those done. Wait in this chest. I probably should increase this transporters here, they're a bit slow, so I've probably got enough now, yes. So let's go and make the muffling upgrades. Each machine, as I said, can take 4. We've got 7 machines, and probably another one we can muffle as well. So let's do that. 32, fantastic. In fact, I've just got enough space in my inventory, which is actually rather unusual. Let's do it like this. We'll eat as we go along, make sure we're healthy. This is a survival game after all, even though it's done a bit like a tutorial, but it is a survival game. So here we have the injection factory, and that's actually turned off, but let's have a look. So we've got gas is supported, speed is supported, and muffling. So let's put the 4 mufflers in here and go to the next machine. This one is that basically turned off because it's got high. But let's put a lever on this one again. It had a lever on at one time, and I think I took it off because it wasn't a really sensible place for it. If I turn it on, they should carry on. That's set to high. The lever's on. Maybe there's another lever on this that I can't see. Nope. Oh, I know what the problem is. No gas. Yes, I remember. What I've done is I've turned off these machines here. I basically said, okay, this one's on high, so it's not producing any gas at the moment. In fact, one of these tanks is sodium, if I remember rightly, and there is no use for sodium at all. That's right. In this game, so we could probably just simply dump it. So let's put a switch on here. Where should we put it? On the top? Yeah, let's put it on the top. Makes sense. And turn that on. That should then start to produce gas. And this, I did the same thing over here as well. Oh. Let's put it on the front then. And turn that on. And that'll produce hydrogen and it'll carry on then. It's a bit messy. I don't like that. Never mind. Let's go back to what we were doing. So now, next machine, muffling upgrades. Let's check we've got all the upgrades in here. So it's got gas, that's fine, speed, muffling, and energy, of course. And I think that's a lot, so let's make sure it's got muffling in here. And the next machine, which is the noisy one, it's a crusher, so we can get that in fairly fast. And I don't think there are any other upgrades that can go into here. So this is now going to be fully upgraded. Still a weeny bit noisy. This one, what can this take? Can this take, yes, it can take muffling, so I'll go on to the next one. I know this one could take muffling, because this is quite a noisy machine as well. And smelting factory, what's it got? Energy, speed, and muffling it can also take. I might have missed a machine out, which is, this is the crushing factory, isn't it? Yes, I have. Now we should, from this one, easily hear the differences. Yes, you see? Now it's fully upgraded with muffling, so we should just be able to hear it a little bit. Oh, can't hear it at all. But the only thing we can actually hear is the logistical sorter clicking as things are going through. Okay, so now all these machines are upgraded. Let's have a look what we've got here. Chemical infuser, that can take energy, speed, and muffling. Let's give it some muffling, and let's go and get some energy upgrades for this as well. Speed upgrades, I mean. So we'll take a, make a set of speed, and we'll make a set of, so what do we need? 8 of these. Let's make 16. 16 osmium and 16 gold. And I'll need 32 glass, and I'll need 32 enriched alloys for those, I think. Maybe 64. Oh, wrong chest. We go through this enriched alloy it's just like tons of it. And glass I should have, but I might not have enough in this chest, we might have to make some more. Got 31 in there, gives me 47. Let's have a look, see if what we can make with those. So we'll do speed first of all, and if you've got enough, we'll do some energy. Otherwise, I'll have to make some more glass. My goodness, right. So speed upgrades. That's the Osmium one, so I can do 16 of those. And I've not quite got enough for the energy, but in fact, I don't think I've got enough at all for the energy. Let's have a look. I can do 7. So I need some more glass. Right, let's go make some more glass while we're waiting. And the next thing we're going to do today is I'm going to upgrade the tank, the dynamic tank, make it a little bit bigger. I'll take 2 stacks of that, because we're going to need it anyway. I should just stick those 2 into there like that. And I'm going to also upgrade the thermal evaporation plant. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go down. We'll see how I'm going to do that in a minute. So what I want to do, first of all, here, is to get rid of all of the brine. So I want to keep the brine in this tank. So how am I going to do that? Let's have a look. Well, I'm actually planning to do that underground. So here's some dynamic tank. And I don't know, this is the first time I've done it, if it'll actually work. If I break the blocks at the bottom, it's going to work. But I've already dug it out here. So if I now take away these blocks at the bottom, let's take this Paxel here. I only need to do the middle ones. Oops, they actually only need to do that middle one, don't I? And I can put that back here, and then I can just simply go around here like this. I'll fill in this as well, because that was just for me. That was just to give me enough space to get down here. I can get out. That's good. So make it like that, and then we can fill this in. Oops, wrong. I missed out this corner here. Let's just take off this sand here. Right, you saw that then go sort of the redstones. What have we got now? We've got now a volume of 36, so that's great. That's actually been upgraded. So let's just go up here. And now that we should be able to take the brine out of this machine here. We can, good. So what I want to do now is to basically break this machine. So let's do that. I'm going to call it machine. It's not really, it's a plant. It's a multi-block structure. So it's still be in wrench mode. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a digital miner here. And let the digital miner dig it down below the current level. So at the moment this is height 3. What I'm going to do is just check I have my inventory's not too full. It is a bit full. Let's just put some junk in the chest here before I start. Well, I don't need this gold upgrades yet. Actually, I'll keep the arrow, never know. And I'll remove these 2. Actually, I've got some speed upgrades in there, already made, and somewhere. That was clever. It's out of the way for the time being anyway. Right, now I should have enough space. But they never do any harm, put it like that. So what I want to do is I want to go down below from where I am, rather than go up, because when it gets high, it gets actually quite difficult to control, but it's no problem going down. So just remove this last few blocks at the top here. Right, good. Right, that should be enough. I've got enough blocks down here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the digital miner down, say, here, but I'll just put it up one block, I think. Let's go to that chest again. And let's get up some sandstone. Like this. Let's put the sandstone down here. It's probably the easiest thing to do is to actually dig a 5x5, but I think I might do a 3x3. So a 3x3 may be, say, here. Yes, I'll do a 3x3 and then move it to here and then do another 3x3. That's what I'm going to do. So let's take the digital miner here, so, and put it down here, for instance. I don't need to give it huge amounts of power, but we will give it a little bit of power. Because we don't need to have Silk Touch on, we can simply just harvest everything that's there. Try that again. And we want the one of these advanced solar panels just to power this thing. Let's put it on, stand out of the way a bit, put it on wrong. Try that again. How many times have I done that? And then we can simply turn this around, right click it. Now that should have power. So it's a good idea not to do that with that one. Let's have a look at this. Right. So what I'm going to do here is I've got Silk Touch on, which I'm going to turn off. And we're going to work out the levels. So this was a two, this was already three high, and the maximum height for these is 18. Oops, I got a block over there. So what we need to do then is to go down 16 levels from where we are, because that was down one. So 16 minus 18 minus the 2 at the top is 16. So we'll go down from 16 from this position. And the current height is 70. So we want to go down to 54. So let's configure this first of all. In fact, I've already set it up to do 52, which was too deep. But let's get to 54. Try again. That's the minimum. Radius of 0, it actually just does a single column all the way down. But we want a radius of 1. And then that will give us a 3 block. There's no filters in, but it's in inverse, so it will dig everything up. We don't care about pulling, but just because there's nothing to pull, so anyway, we'll just let it get on and start that. So it's got 120 blocks to do, which won't take very long at all. It won't have enough power, so it'll go a bit slow towards the end. But we should be able to see. You can hear it mining away. It actually starts from the bottom and works its way up. I might need to do this to 60, to level 69 actually. I'm a bit confused as to where I do it to. This is actually 69 here. So maybe that should have been the top layer. Let's have a look, how's it going now? 31 to go, so we should see it coming up. And you'll see it's just about got enough energy to finish this off. From one solar panel. And there we go. So it's basically dug, it was the one level that below I wanted to do, so it was 69. So now it's dug down, and as you can see, there's actually a cave just at the back there. So now let's just move this around. Just thinking how to do it. So we want it basically to put it here now, like that. So we should be able to shift click everything away without losing it. So yeah, got that one. So the last bit is this. And of course the digital miner would have to fall down. Let's go and get it. And you'll see there's a cave here. So we now know that this level here should be 54. Let's check it. It says 55. That might be perfect, actually. I'm not 100% certain. We'll find out. So let's go up. Ooh, too far, never mind. So now we want to put the digital miner here and just mine up the last corner, as it were. It's probably not going to work exactly as I want it to, but it doesn't matter. We can simply manually do the rest if it's the need arises. So where's it gone to? Here we are. All we need to do now is power it. Yeah, I'll put it down here because the other side's actually in use. Change that so we don't click that again. Let's just, it's full of power. So let's just start that, let that go. Actually, let's stop that. I wanted to go one layer below, didn't I? Let's say we reset it and go back to configuration. So I want this at 69. I actually did say 55, didn't I? Let's go back. Let's go to 54. I missed that first time, so we started that. So 68 to do, won't take very long at all. And we might be able to see it doing its work actually. This particular bit won't be dug up. And neither will this column, but we can do these two columns very quickly. Right, smashing. So I'll just quickly dig this column down here. Like that. In fact, I just don't know where the bottom piece is. I'll do this corner as well. The worst case is I have to basically come down and do this again and just put the last layer in. So I'm just 100% not sure. So let's just start. So we now know it's a 4x4. I'll leave the space below here. It doesn't matter very much. So let's get on with this. Now I haven't got enough blocks, but that we've got plenty of. I've actually already prepared those. Let's just stand on this and do the last four here. So then we just do the sides. So this is layer two. I stand up on that and then carry on. You should be able to reach all of this actually without any problem. Right, not got enough materials. Let's go up and get the rest of the materials. In fact, while I'm doing that, let's just pick up this. Drop down again. Go and get it. Don't want it to despawn. Right. See how useful that jetpack is. In fact, it's running out of hydrogen. I could fill it up while we're here, in fact. But I'll finish doing this tank for this thermal evaporation plant first, I think. And I think in here. No, mechanism bits. I've got another 50 thermal evaporation blocks. Hopefully that's going to be enough. We've made these before, so I'm not going to go through the recipe of that again. Well, basically it was 18 times, that's 16 times 4, isn't it? 64, we haven't got enough then. Oops, missed that corner block. Yep, run out already. In fact, I'm not sure what I've got in terms of bits prepared for this. I did prepare some. It's just a sign. So what we actually need for that was copper. We've got plenty of copper. I've got plenty of copper here and 12. That'll give me basically, that should give me 27. We'll do 28. And we need some steel. We've got plenty of steel. Well, I haven't got that much steel actually. We need to make some more steel. So, well, now we've got these souped up factories, we can actually get some steel made fairly quickly as well. But it might use the brine up from the dynamic tank, but I don't know yet, we'll see. So I've got lots of iron dust and some gold, some glass. Now let's just take the glass out and get the iron dust converted to ingots, because we need that in ingot form. And we also need some more compressed carbon. We'll make what we can to start with, I think. So that's actually an awkward number. I'll make some more, another stack of compressed carbon. Because 11, you need to be, that makes 88, doesn't it? So we need, that would give them 44. steel. Carbon, I think, is in here. Yes, it is. So just charcoal, of course. In fact, we need to put that into the enrichment chamber. Let's get do that first. No, I can't now, can I? Oh, that's metallurgy confuser. Yes, I can. So let's put that in the enrichment chamber. That should then make carbon, some more compressed carbon. And we want 44 iron. And that should complete that lot out of there. We should have already got stacks of iron. See, that's really coming in fast. So let's have a look. 32 plus 10, we're at 12. And that should be, if I put those into here, 88 exactly. So it basically needs two. So the first time round will produce dusts, enriched iron dusts, and the second round will produce steel dusts. And I'm going to keep this open, and then we'll get steel ingots, which is what we actually need. So we've got 64 more compressed carbon, so that's going to give us a lot more steel. What else have I got in here? I don't want. Got some osmium ore. Let's just ship that into here as well for the sake of it. And get our 8 osmium ingots out of there. Oh yes, that's right, I'm making these copper things, aren't I? So the recipe for that was basically copper ingots surrounded by, or a plus of, steel. If I remember correct, do you remember this recipe? That's going to give me 4. That'll give me 64 blocks. That's probably going to be enough, actually. Let's just not do the whole lot. 40 may be enough. Let's just, can always come back and make some more. If that isn't sufficient, it's not. Actually, there's no point in wasting them. I will need to build another solar air thermal evaporation plant at some stage. Oh, maybe I do need to do that again. I could take a piece of paper and pencil and do their calculation, couldn't I? Because it's 16 minus 4, so it's 12 per row, and we need another 16 rows. Oh, I can't do that calculation in my head, but I reckon I ain't got enough. Yeah. Up we go again and do another block. I want to be over here, don't we? Yeah, I've got still got enough. 26, let's just do that recipe again. In the middle and then across of steel. This time I'm not going to waste too much time. I'm just going to put them all in. Actually, while I'm thinking about it, let me just start my calculator up here. In my head. I still don't think I've got enough blocks. Doesn't look like it, does it? Because that's going to give me 2 rows, so I'll end up with just 2 rows. But we should have some more steel ingots by the time I finish doing this, so we'll have plenty to carry on. So we should end up with 1 space short on the second row. So we need at least 36, maybe 40. In fact, the steel's over here now, isn't it? And sure enough, I've got 44 steel already in, which is, of course, exactly what we made. Let's go and get the others. 64, let's take that 64 and then do another. That will do, I think that'll do 128 steel. We can soon find out. Let's just take 1 stack of iron, complete stack of iron, that is, and sort that in fact, and put that into this chest up here. And then that'll go off and then start to produce steel. And here we'll get to, hopefully, by the time we finish this, I'll have enough steel to do that. Now I've got some more steel as well, but I think we might have enough now. It's going to give me 36, so 44, yes, of course. It makes exactly sense. The same number as the steel ingots I had there. With a bit of luck, we'll have enough to do the three rows and the top two rows as well. In the earlier versions, this was much worse. It was basically a thermal evaporation or salination plant was all copper blocks. Right, that is basically almost enough. Maybe I'm one or two short. So what we need now is, of course, we put the valve down here and a valve down here. And then we have, just need to fill in this row here and then do the top row. So we still need a complete row here, so that's probably not going to be enough, is it? No, exactly. So we need another 3 plus 4, we need another 7. So you end up with, to make a full size tank, you end up with a lot. Haven't got it yet there. I've got 3 down here, so let's go and get the other stuff. It's possible I've got some in one of these chests. No, I am completely out of steel. How many copper ingots have I got there? 9. Actually, that's going to be enough. I think that's going to give us 9 for 36. So I just have to now wait for the steel ingots to come back into here. Ah, we've got 7 already. So they're now coming in. It doesn't take too long, fortunately, for me at the moment. 21. That'll be enough anyway. We need about 8. But we are going to need to build another salination, thermal evaporation plant for reactors. So I don't mind having extras. So let's go again. Simply right clicking these, of course, halve them. And there we go. Let's just turn the pyre and do the last row like this. I'm also hoping I haven't gone too deeply down as well. That would be also a pain. Yes, that's got made. So let's go and have a look and see if we've got 18 levels and my calculations are about right. That seems to have got blocked. Hopefully we don't get a crash. Oh, height 17. Okay, great. That's actually not too bad at all. Let's just break it up here. One more block. Go down and we'll do the 18th row down the bottom. I've got enough. I've got 10 more. I only need, I need 12, don't I? For a layer. Okay, let's go and get the 12th one. In fact, I also see a yellow marker here, so let's put a torch down on top of one of these. That should stop those going mob spawning. And it looks like I'm going to have to make more steel in between episodes. So what I'm going to do next after this, I was going to do turbines, but this is part of the preparation for turbines. Oops, what did I just do then? Recipe for that one. That's plenty, 26. And for turbines, we're going to need more basically capacity of everything. So let's just drop down here and then go down this last layer. Of course, it might be fun getting out of here, but we can do it from bottom up. So I did actually get my calculations reasonably okay. Use the stone pixel. Pick up that cobblestone. And then we just put them down here. Come up. If I can get out, which I should be able to here. And then put down the controller again, and then we should get the maximum height block. Again, I've clicked this, and it's sort of got a weight icon. So there we go, height 18 formed. So the production of this will now be fairly fast. What's it doing? 2 millibuckets per tick. Going up rapidly. What time of day is it? It's morning, so we should get a full day's run. Let's have a look at this tank. And we can see that brine is coming in at a reasonably high rate. It's climbing fairly smoothly. So, that's it. Next time, I'm going to start with the next level of machinery for quintupling 5 times or from 1. Basic ore. So until then, bye for now.